Everyone, Archie here, and welcome back to another Sims 4 spill build. I hope you all have an awesome day, and if not, maybe this video will put a small smile on your face. And in this video, we are gonna build something that I never done before, at least not in this channel. And I think I've done it like off the camera, and I do remember that I've done something like that in Sims 3, but in Sims 4 I never done it. And I said, why not to try and do it? Now, we are building a house that is, let's face it, it's a rock bottom house. It is a starter rock bottom house. I think it's really, it can be really, really cool to create a Sims that actually doesn't need much to live, okay? And then place it on this house. And the beauty of this house is because I used like a lot, but a lot of the new 1000 items, I actually saved a lot of money. Because those items, for those of you who don't know, most of the items in the cheat codes of the 1000 new items are zero, like in their price is zero simoleons. So you basically can use a lot of them and you will like raise the beauty of your design, but will not raise the amount of money your house required to purchase, okay? So yeah, I created a house that is, it is a rock bottom. You can just watch and look how, or of course you watch the cinematic at the start and you can understand how really, really like it's not living friendly, but if your Sims doesn't need much to live, this is the perfect house for you. At the end, this house costs your Sims only like 16 or 17,000 simoleons to live in. And I think that's super cheap, considering that a lot of people, when they're building a new modern house or a house for starter Sims, the people that are building the houses using most of the budget, if not all of it, like the last, even for the last penny on this budget, they will spend the whole 20,000 on the lot and on the house to create the most beautiful house they can create with that budget. But then when your Sims purchase this house, this starter house, they don't have starter money, so they cannot really pay the bill or buy themselves some useful items that will help them build their own skills or stuff like that. They have to just run fast to find a new job, so they will be able to create some money to live in their beautiful but really expensive starter home. So the idea behind this design was to give you a house that is really bad shaped, but you can start with something in your bank account in the game. So at the end, after you buy this house, your Sims will be able to buy themselves some useful items like computers or maybe a canvas or stuff like that that they need in order to build their skills and start live. Okay, and of course, after some quite of time, while they are having a really bad home, but they can actually live because they have a bit money, of course, you can make them go to create something or become someone and find a job that will bring them some money. Then you will be able to sell this really crooked house and move on to a better house. Of course, by the way, I do have some houses on my gallery that you can download as a second houses. You know that houses in this game, like you can categorize them by their price as a starter home, and of course like a more advanced home with a bit more rooms and stuff like that. I do have some of those on my gallery account, so you're more than welcome to go and check them out, and maybe you'll find some houses that you enjoy. So you're more than welcome. So yeah, so this is a starter home. Of course, this is in the categories of a tiny house that your Sims can start living. And as you can see that, because I'm using a lot of the debugs 1000 items, it ends up really, really detailed. and I really wanted to give you the feeling of a wrecked house, a really low society house. But at the same time, because I'm using those 1,000 items, it did not raise the amount of money this house required to purchase. So yeah, that is a big advantage for your Sims when you are going to buy this house, because they can live in this house and have a little bit more money than usual when they are buying a new house that someone spent all of their budget building that house. By the way, let me know which one of those two types of persons you are in the comment section. Are you the one who will spend the whole budget creating a starter home with like 20,000 simoleons, and that's the starter home for you? Or you are the one who will try to be like money saver and build a house that is not the best in its look, but will save you a bit money for your Sims to start their life in this game? Let me know in the comment section down below which one of those two types of person you are. Anyway, we are getting closer and closer to the end of the video. We are not really at the end, but we are getting closer, and you can see the exterior. I really invested time on the exterior of this house because I really want to be like a haunted, low budget, rock bottom starter house. So I even decided to put graves on it, like the previous person died there and stuff like that. And of course the broken roof and tiles and stuff that really give you the spooky feeling to this house. So yeah, I really had a great time making this house. I really did. I hope you are guys enjoying watching this video, and if you do, do not forget to show your support of the channel by hitting that like button, share the video with your friends, and if you are new here and your first time watching my videos, you're more than welcome to join the family. Hit that subscribe button and check out some other videos I have on my channel. I really have a big variety or selection of types of builds on my channel, so you're more than welcome to check them out. My previous video, I created a car dealership, and if you missed it, by the way, you're more than welcome to check it out. I will leave a link in the description down below for you, all of you, to enjoy it. Another topic, for those of you who are following me on Twitter, and for those of you who don't, I just want to let you know that the third part of my little project that I create small rooms with the 1,000 items, I just uploaded a update about this project, and the third part is now out, and you're more than welcome to go and check it on my account on the Sims Gallery. All of those rooms are over there. The previous one, I think I uploaded like fences and broken fences. Fences I use in this design are on that part, on the third part, and some items that used for building cities. Okay, you have there like traffic lights and some poles and stuff like that that are related to city building and street building and stuff like that. So you're more than welcome to go and grab yourself those rooms. I will put a link in the description for you to go and get them. And I didn't use those rooms on this design, and the reason for that is because this design was on a smaller lot, so I couldn't really grab those rooms and put them on my current lot and use them, because I didn't really have the space for that. So I don't think that I'm not using my creations. I do, but especially on this design, I couldn't really do it. But I hope you you guys at home will be able to do it. So make sure to get yourself those rooms. They are really, really useful. It saves you a lot of time of scrolling down the cheat codes. And by the way, you don't even have to activate the cheat codes if you are using those rooms. So so get yourself those rooms and enjoy them. Anyway, we are getting closer to the end of this video. You are seeing the inside being created right now. In a bit you will see I even created a hole in the on the floor. It was I really think it's cool, and as you can see, I really tried to create this design as a rock bottom house. So the stuff are not matching each other. You can see some chairs that are not even the same colors. They are like someone just throw them into the space. They are not arranged in a normal way. It's a bit messy, right? So that was the idea. That was the vibe that I was trying to bring into this design. Anyway, one small thing before we are really at the end of this video. It's regarding the next video. I noticed some of you are asking for me to create a renovation or fixer-upper a video about the Goff's family house. So there is a good chance that will be the next video. So stay tuned for that. I even have some ideas about how to do it. I even thought about recreating the original house on top of this house, like merge them somehow together. Don't worry, I will find a new version or a new look to that old house. Anyway, that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and until the next time, keep that Sims party going for me, Ojar Gaming, signing off.